Okay, guys, you know what that sound means? It's time to decorate this room for Christmas!
Yay! What's all this commotion?
Miss Rebecca, we're decorating our room for Christmas.
It's almost Christmas. We want to decorate together.
Uh-huh. I don't think it's a very good idea to decorate our rooms together. I think it's a great idea!
Yay! I don't see any reason we can't get this tree trimmed from top to bottom!
Yay!
Woo! I will say, though, it doesn't look very festive without decorations. We need some color!
Color indeed. Speaking of color, do you guys know that the colors of Christmas have symbolic meaning?
I've always been partial to silver. It reminds me of the braces Autumn got a few years ago.
Very funny.
That's not exactly what I had in mind. There's a lot of symbolism in the colors of Christmas. In fact, each color points directly to the story of Jesus as told in the Bible.
Huh. Well, I never knew that. That is interesting.
Yeah. So let's start with the color green.
Yeah, I hope old Crip. Yeah, green as in cash. I hope old Grandpa starts my stocking again with Benjamin.
Hello? Oh, I think Miss Morgan was talking about the tree.
You're right. 7 feet of glorious green.
Glorious? Looks pretty dull and bare to me right now.
Oh, come on. You have to look deeper. It's glorious because green is the color of life. We decorate evergreen trees and hang green garlands this time of year to be reminded that Jesus came to earth to give us life. Can anybody remember a time in the Bible that talks about life? Oh, yeah, okay.
John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that for whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Exactly. God gave us Jesus so that we can have eternal life. So, every time you see green at Christmas, or any time of the year, remember that Jesus came to earth so that we can live with him forever.
Thank you. you are making us new.
Take a look in that box right there and maybe start getting out some decorations.
I'm all over it.
What you see in there?
I found some things for the table, but there's not much Christmas color, but I'm sure you don't like the nativity scene.
Let's see. Actually, there are some really important Christmas colors here.
There is?
Yeah.
There is.
Take a look at Mary. What color is she wearing?
Blue.
Hey, I got it. This is where Elvis got the idea for, I'll have a blue Christmas.
All right, rock star. I don't think that's what Miss Morgan wants us to remember.
Good guess, but not quite right. In the days when Jesus was born, the color blue was worn only by nobility. So think people of power and great importance. Traditionally, Mary is depicted in blue clothing, signifying that she's to give birth to the King of Kings. Whenever we see Mary dressed in blue, we are to remember the proclamation that the angel gave to her. It's found in Luke chapters 1, verses 30 through 33. Let's read it. Let's see if I can find it. It says, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
Wow, that's cool.
It is really cool. But that's not the only Christmas color we're looking at right now.
It isn't?
No. Like, let's look at the manger scene. What other color do you see that stands out?
The only thing I see is an old brown shepherd's cloak.
That's exactly right. Good.
What?
Brown? Oh, I get it. Oh, then he ran over for him.
Oh, Michael, you crack me up.
Brown isn't Christmas color, is it?
Actually, absolutely it is. People don't often think about brown at Christmas time, but there is great symbolic meaning here. The shepherds in a traditional manger scene are often depicted wearing brown cloaks. These garments serve as a reminder for the wooden manger where Christ laid as a baby, and 33 years later, where Christ hung as Savior of all mankind.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amazing.
So whenever we see shepherds dressed in brown and kneeling at the manger, we are to remember the announcement of the angel unto Joseph, found in Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. We are to remember both the manger and the cross of Christ, his miraculous birth and his sacrificial death. Well, you guys are doing a great job with this nativity scene. It looks great. Let's see if we can dig in another box and see if we can pull out some ornaments for the tree.
I'm on it.
Okay. Oh, cool.
Look what I found. Candy canes. Candy canes are red and white. What else is red and white at Christmas? The suit of the jolly old red elf himself.
Well, that's right, but not exactly what we're looking for. Let's hang these on the tree.
You've gotta be kidding me!
Remember, Miss Morgan said the colors of Christmas all point up to the story of Jesus.
Red and white. Oh, I give up.
I think I can answer that one. Red represents the blood that was shed by Jesus when he died on the cross for our redemption, which was God's rescue of all mankind from sin and death and hell. So if that's what red represents, does anyone know what white means?
I do.
Well, okay, Abby, tell us. So if red is the blood of Jesus, what is white?
cleanses us from sin?
That's right.
The colors red and white are used just about everywhere at Christmas, so we're always being reminded that Jesus' blood washes us white as snow.
You're right, Evelyn. Our red and white decorations remind us that the baby in the manger became the Lamb of God whose blood was shed for all of us. No matter who we are or what we've ever done, the Christ child of Bethlehem became the Redeemer for all of us.
But it sure is beginning to look a whole lot more like Christmas in here.
It sure is.
Hey, look! Here it is!
Oh, great! You found the star, yes.
I sure did. Can I put it on top of the tree?
Sure.
I'll help you get it up there.
Oh, please be careful.
We did it.
We did.
It looks beautiful.
Well, way to go, you guys. You make a good team.
Gold.
Gold what?
The star, it's gold.
Yep, that it is.
Well, I think I might know this one.
Okay, give it a shot. What do you think?
I remember when the three wise men from the east followed the star, and they brought the finest gifts they could give to Jesus. One brought myrrh, another brought frankincense, and one even brought gold.
Sounds like Evelyn's got it.
I think she does. You know, kids, gold is widely known as the most precious and pure gift that anyone on earth can afford. People make fine jewelry out of gold. Others give away trophies made of gold to the very best teams. And some people even furnish the finest palaces in the world with gold. Gold ribbons, gold medals, gold membership. It all means the very best. Wouldn't you agree, Rain?
So when we see gold at Christmas time, we should remember the three gifts of the wise king.
Yes! Yes, that is exactly right. Just like the three wise kings who gave their best gifts to Jesus, we are to give our best gifts to him in worship. And we also remember that God gave us the very best gift possible, eternal life, when he raised Jesus from the dead. So we, in response, are to give our lives and hearts to him. We are to live for him to the best of our ability, holy and set apart for his glory. We give our best to God because he gave his best to us.
Like the wise men who have journeyed far across the desert sands, bringing all the greatest treasure, the finest things in all the land.
I'm bowing down before you just to say that I adore you.
And I give I'm
You know what? I think this room looks better than ever for Christmas.
I agree. This room looks pretty great.
Knowing what all the colors mean, seeing the decorations seem even brighter. The story comes to life in living color.
Savannah, I couldn't have said it better. We've recounted the whole story of Christmas, color by color. So kids, when you're out there decking the halls and seeing the colors of Christmas, I hope you remember how they point us to the story of Jesus. I tell you what though, being surrounded by all this vivid color makes me want to sing. Let's finish our night in celebration. Let's sing some carols and worship together, shall we?
You'd like to, you can stand up.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth and sea be praised.
Didn't they do good? These folks here have done a great job helping us kick off some of our Christmas celebrations. I just want to let you know about a couple more things we have going on in the coming weeks. We will be having a candlelight service this coming Wednesday at 7 o'clock. And then next Sunday morning at 10:30, we'll be gathering for a worship service. Did you ladies want to? Okay.
Well, thank you all for coming. It's been really fun to work with all of these children. Really good excuse to get to come here more and practice with the kids. But even more of a better excuse is to work with Penny and Denise. For as long as I can remember, really just participating in all of the children's events and directing me when I was a kid, and we really do appreciate it. Without Denise and Penny, this wouldn't have... Oh, okay, well, for hindsight, I'm not that old. I'm like 16. So it's not been that long. Where Rebecca and I have some presents for Denise and Penny that we'd like to give them. When you get a chance, please recognize Penny and Denise because they've dedicated lots of time to this.